Hello and welcome back. And today I want to talk about another new release from the guys at QNAP being unveiled at CES 2020 in Vegas. Today I want to continue talking about 10GBE because let's face it, they've been hitting that subject hard, and talk about their brand new managed network switch supporting 10 gigabit Ethernet. This is the QSW M408 series. It's arriving in two versions and it's an alternate approach to a device I have a box for up here. I don't know whether you can see that. Let's get that down. This is the QSW 308. This was released back in 2019, but this device is an unmanaged 10GBE switch. And what we're talking about today is an alternative route for that device. This is the new 10GBE managed switch in fiber and copper, and it is a low power, affordable, no noise switch that has got the management features and functionality that QNAP have been working on, that we've seen in things like the Guardian, which is QNET switch. And I do believe this will be using a very similar program, if not a slightly more streamlined version. And it is an 8-port 1GBE switch that arrives with either 4 SFP 10GBE ports, so that's fiber, or it's going to be arriving with 4 SFP fiber and 4 copper ports in combo mode. And what that means is you can pair SFP ports and 10GBE base T copper ports together in pairs for link aggregation and connectivity. And remember, because this is a managed switch, you do have things like quality of service control, link aggregation control, port priority, and more. So this is definitely going to be a slightly more desirable device than that network switch they released previously. Because I don't know about you guys, but when I'm creating a network environment, and I do use network appliances quite a lot, an unmanaged switch is great for day one, maybe even day two. But apart from that, afterwards you will always feel the limitations, whether it's when you've got someone on the network hogging all the bandwidth, or do you want to take advantage of that link aggregation? And with ports these days arriving with support of 2.5 GBE, 5 GBE and more, taking advantage of link aggregation and the faster enhanced speeds that hard drives, SSDs, SSD caching and more can provide in a NAS is something a lot of you will want to take advantage of, and one of the main reasons for the driving force behind the M408 being developed. Now, if you did watch my hardware review of this device over here, you'll know that it is tiny. It's about this big, and it's got a rotating PSU that comes off very easy. Hopefully there's a graphic or a picture on screen. And it was fantastically affordable. It's still one of the lowest priced 10GBE switches you can buy. And the the M408 can only promise to do the same. Now, don't get me wrong, I don't know much more than that about this device right now. For example, will it be using the Aquantia controllers inside? Will it have its own dedicated CPU? And what will that CPU be to handle the switch management? It doesn't need to be very powerful. It's not like the Guardian needing a NAS and a switch combined. Also, it is a low power device. It doesn't have a fan. The whole thing is devised with heat sinks and very tactically placed fans around the chassis. So it's a very interesting device nonetheless, but it's definitely a simple device and not one that you're going to have to think too much about when buying. And if you are entering the world of 10GBE, don't get me wrong, I still think the unmanaged switch has legs, and it's something to think about going for if you're going to make the tippy toe step into 10GBE, where you need to support a bunch of 1GBE users and maybe attach a 10 gigabit Ethernet NAS and then make sure all of those users get their full 1GBE. Or if you're going to be thinking about moving slightly forward beyond that, this is where you make the change or the choice between the 308 and the M408, because they're targeting the same group. It's just the depth and breadth of the way they're going to work. But I'm going to wrap things up here. We've got a few more new releases from QNAP from CES and a bunch of other brands too, so do stay tuned. There's a cat down there trying to get into my office, and I'm just going to let that happen. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Again, click subscribe to learn more, and if you enjoyed this, click like, and there's lots of information about these products in the description with links and NAS compares and span. I'll see you guys next time.